Do you want to know what the signs are that you are texting with a narcissist? In this video, I'm going to give you 5 signs that the person who's on the other end of that phone may just be a narcissist. Hi, I'm Rebecca Zung, and I have been recognized by a number of organizations as one of the top 1% of attorneys in the country, and I have written a couple of best-selling books, Negotiate Like You Matter and Breaking Free, Step-by-Step Divorce Guide, and more importantly for you, I have helped millions of people in negotiating with and dealing with and getting out of relationships with narcissists. So if that sounds good to you and you want to get out of that relationship with that narcissist, whether it's a business relationship or a romantic relationship or just a friend relationship, then hit subscribe and hit that notification bell. So let's talk about whether or not you're texting with a narcissist on the other side. So the first little cue that you're going to get is that love bombing. So remember, relationships with narcissists usually always start off with something that looks like what we call love bombing, which is that they come on super strong as the most amazing person. And it's almost like a little bit overwhelming. If you want to know more about love bombing, I would definitely check out my video just on love bombing. But basically, it's just that they come on super strong. Like, you know, they're just in your face all the time. You almost can't even breathe because they don't want to give you a chance to like think or anything like that. So right away, they're making plans. They're telling you how amazing you are, that you're perfect, that they can be perfect for you. So, you know, if it's in a business setting, they can bring you the best clients, the most money, they have all the right contacts, they have the best skills, whatever it is you're looking for, they've done it before, they've done it super successfully, they can introduce you to all the right people, whatever it is, they're very good at honing in on whatever it is that they see that you want or need or would be good for you. And so they'll do the same thing in text messages. So suddenly you're being love bombed. You're just like, you're so beautiful. You're so amazing. You're so successful. I can't believe I met someone like you. How lucky is it? We are perfect for each other. This whole thing is meant to be. And maybe people will say things like that and they're not narcissists, obviously. But this is just one sort of little indication. If it feels like, oh my gosh, it's a little much, they're coming on really, really strongly, then maybe it's a possibility that you're being love bombed by a narcissist, unfortunately. So number 2 is they talk a lot about themselves. So, you know, every single time you're in a text conversation with this person, they're telling you that what's going on in their work, what in their day, what's happening with them. They can't believe that this happened. This crisis is going on, and all about them. And they never really ask about you. Or it might just be sort of like an afterthought. Oh yeah, well, and how are you doing? Okay. And then they never even respond to that. Like you tell them and then they don't respond to that. So if there's a lot of talk about themselves and a lot of talk about their own issues, and you just find yourself texting back, spending quite a lot of time just going on and on about helping them. And of course, you know, you, if you're getting into the relationship with this narcissist, are probably an empath. You're probably a person who feels very deeply for people, who wants to help people, who feels like you can save people or you care so much. Then, you know, it's probably just really second nature for you to just go, how are you? And oh my gosh, and this is terrible. And you're just, you don't mind actually for a lot of it helping this other person and pouring yourself into this other person. But then at some point you start to realize, well, wait a minute, they don't actually ever ask about me. How is that going on? I mean, and you think, well, am I being selfish? You know, but no, I mean, at some point the other person should be, you know, how is your day going or what's going on with you or something in that text message conversation. So if there's a whole lot of stuff about themselves, then maybe that's an indication that you are texting with a narcissist. And by the way, if you want to know more about narcissistic favorite phrases, you should definitely check out my video on the narcissist's favorite phrases. So the next one is going to be like future faking or saying things that, you know, we are going to go and do all of these things. The future is going to be amazing for us. We're going to create this amazing business. We are going to go do things together. If it's a romantic relationship or a friendship, they might plan a lot of different things with you in the text messages. And then they never really come to fruition. Like, what's going on with that? And, Or you know, the next one might be just that they're completely not responding to you at all. And sometimes that can be called ghosting or whatever, but just not responding to you at all can also be something that they can do, you know, where you respond back to them and then all of a sudden they're not responding to you. Now it's like days have gone by. And so you're like back and forth between this love bombing and this like devalue in the form of, you know, getting the silent treatment from them or no contact from them at all, or ghosting. So, and if you want to know more about the differences between silent treatment, no contact, and ghosting, check out my video on that. But you really, it can be very confused sometimes because they're, you know, what we call future faking, meaning that they're planning all this stuff with you and then you respond back and now all of a sudden you're not hearing from them anymore. Maybe they go dark for a day or two or even longer. And then when you start to ask them, hey, how come you went dark on me? They get mad at you. And, you know, how come you're you know, all of a sudden you're all over me? You can't leave me alone. You're badgering me, something like that. And this is the person who was also love bombing you, is saying, you know, you were so perfect for each other. And so it can be very, very confusing. And that's where you start to feel devalued. And your brain is like going back and forth between, you know, happiness and joy and confusion and hurt and pain constantly back and forth. And that's where you start to develop, you know, trauma and toxic thinking, like your brain starts feeling very scrambled because of all of this back and forth. And if you are just shaking your head saying, oh my gosh, this is so wrong, just give me an SMH in the comments for shaking my head, SMH. And the fourth example of a text from a narcissist is a lot of bragging. So they do a lot of bragging about their accomplishments, all the things that they're doing, how everybody else is so stupid, how everybody else was inept at work and they were so smart and how they came up with all this, you know, some innovative thing, or that they, you know, stopped something from happening or saved tons of money for the company or whatever it is that they have done. They're just in the text messages, just constantly bragging about their own accomplishments and how everybody else is so inept or stupid or something like that. So that can be definitely an indication that you might be dealing with a narcissist. And the last one is that they send lots of pictures of themselves. So, you know, you get tons of pictures of this narcissist and, you know, it's not pictures of other people or things that are going around them or even asking for pictures of you. They just believe that you must want tons and tons of pictures of them. And so that could definitely be an indication as well. So if you have gotten any of these text messages, I want to see that SMH in the comments. And if you are negotiating with a narcissist and you're getting these texts and you're realizing you're going to have to get into a negotiation with these narcissists or this person, I offer you to download my free Crush My Negotiation Prep Worksheet at winmynegotiation.com. You can just get it at winmynegotiation.com. Come join me also in my free private Facebook group called Narcissist Negotiators with Rebecca Zung. And if you like this video, like, share, drop me a comment, and hit that subscribe button and that notification bell. I'm Rebecca Zung. I am so glad you stopped by my channel today, and I will see you in the next video.